Right, guys, just on my way to Anglesey, like sort of the western point. Gonna do a couple of nights camping there. I had a bit of a nightmare getting here. The engine management light and coil or glow plug light keeps flashing, so I've been having to switch off and back on again. So it's obviously a sensor, it clears it, but it's just been going into like limp mode. So yeah, a bit of a struggle getting here, and obviously I'll have to take it to my trusty mechanic when I get back next week. So obviously just need a new sensor or something. I think it's something to do with the torque, the gearbox or whatever. So anyways, we're nearly there, about half an hour away. I'll put the links in the description where we're staying and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm gonna have a go doing a little like YouTube series. So this is the first one, so I'm sure they'll get better as we go. So yeah, it's just me, little solo camp, two nights, and it's just, you know, to get out there, enjoy my van, and I'll do a couple of little videos of how I've packed stuff and all that good stuff, cooking, a couple of walks, nothing too strenuous. So yeah, see you in a bit. Well, we're nearly there, guys. We're at the coast. I think there's like a lighthouse over there. Might go and walk to that today. The weather's been fantastic on the way in, even though it was saying it was going to be raining. So yeah, we'll see what the weather does for us. Cheers. So we're nearly here. The weather's closing in a little bit. We've had nice blue skies on the way in, and I managed to stop at a little shop and get 24 Sam McGill. So yeah, we're nearly there. I'm just looking out for the sign for the campsite. Oh, there's another van. This might be tight. Right, seeing a bit. Got another pass here. Single track. I've just met the van that was passing over then. The one I let past. He was the owner of the campsite. He recognised me van because I sent him pictures of it. So here we are.
Your destination is on the right.
So it looks like we are here. So here we are. Good stuff. There's already a couple of campers already here. We're not far from the coast. So yeah. Right, guys, so we just got here. One of the fellow campers has just came over and gave me a little tip, saying it was very, very windy last night, like horrendous. So yeah, the clouds are coming in, but it is a little bit windy. But what you expect, it's October and we're by the coast. So yeah, he's got a nice Nissan Patrol on a 90 model, I think. It's really good. I'll try and get some pictures of that, and he's got a rooftop tent on it, so it looks pretty awesome. So yeah, there's lots of sheep about. There's a couple of little estuaries and stuff like that. So there's another camper van. There's like three of us here. So yeah, I'm gonna set up camp now and probably get a cup of coffee on the go. So yeah, and then I'll do a video of some of me kit and that. So yeah, awesome. See you in a bit, guys. stop. I've got myself a loaf, two pot noodles, some brown sauce. I've got some tinned goods, pasta, hot chocolate, coffee, burger buns, Weetabix, some sugars, stuff like that, crisps, Jaffa cakes. Got some beers. And then in the fridge, I've brought a couple of eggs, milk, cordial juice, the beers in, more beers in there. I've brought some salmon, some bacon, butter. And then up here defrosting, I've got some burgers for later. So yeah, I haven't unpacked completely. Yeah, I've just set the small table up there and I've set up the small table here. I've got a bigger table for here, but just put the small one. So yeah, I'm just contemplating now whether to get the ramps, because the van's on a slant slightly, so I might get the ramps, so I'll tune in again with that. Got my eggs on, got my bacon under the grill, and trying to toast some bread. What's the weather doing? Alright guys, just walking to the coast now, I've had some lunch. So yeah, just trying to find my bearings really. So I've come down from the campsite, which was like over that way behind me, and now I'm making my way down to the sea. There's like a fort thing somewhere over there. Very windy, but at least it's dry. See you later, guys. What, 50 mile an hour winds maybe, and rain. Awesome. We're back from Kilmore Fishery in Ireland. Thanks for the seat. So yeah, just have a little rest. I'm gonna take some water in, and then back to camp then. Right, just got back, so I'm gonna get the hot chocolate on, get a quick shower. In my shower, I'm gonna get my night blinds up, so I've got a bit of privacy, because it'll be going dark soon. And I'm gonna unpack, just got the fan on, and the hot water, heating that up. So yeah, and then tonight, I'm gonna be having salmon, I think, salmon and rice.
So I'm going to be having these.
Well,
I have defrosted some other stuff, like, but yeah. So I'm going to be doing that with a few beers. And believe it or not, we can actually get a TV signal as well. So I'll be watching some TV because there's no internet at all. So I'm a bit gutted. So I brought me MacBook. So with a bit of luck, I'll be able to watch something on my MacBook. So yeah, another top tip. I leave these open. If you can leave them open, they don't need to shut. Just leave them open because then you're not wearing your hinges and everything out. So I just leave everything unpopped. And then, yeah, you know, you're not wearing everything out then. And then before you set off, just reset all your poppers and everything. Sound? Right, see you in a bit, guys. Right, so I'm just boiling some water for the boiling a bag of rice. And I've got me salmon in the oven. There's me salmon. So let's have a look at this. Should be boiling now, I think. Getting there, like. So I'll lower this in. Oop. There we go. Flatten it out a bit. Now to puncture the bag. And we'll let that boil. And then I've got this on gas 5 or 6, so I'll keep an eye on that as well. I don't know what all this is, like, I'd say, but it's like sawdust. I clean and then I come back to the van and everywhere's covered in it, so I'll have to do a deep clean. Must be where when they fitted all these cabinets. So yeah, it must be in the stead windy outside as well, and we might get a sunset. So yeah, got some washing up to do, and I'll be getting a beer as well in a bit, I think. And then I'll sort my bed out. But look outside. Clouds are clearing a little bit, so we might get a clear night sky as well. Do a bit of stargazing later. So yeah, rice is on the boil. And I'm just trying to dry shit out. Because got pretty soaked. So I've had my shower, everything. It's quite a decent shower, you know. It's pretty good, like. Blowing a gale out there. Just trying to dry these out before I put them in my dirty washing bag. I don't like putting wet clothes in a bag, like, so. Aye. Also, I'll let you know how it goes in a minute. Nice one. So the rice is boiling. And the salmon looks like it needs turning over.
Yeah, right, guys. Oh well, we had a bit of a storm last night, but as you can see now, it's absolutely fantastic. The very slightest of breeze. It's 10 a.m. and I had a good sleep on the bed. So yeah, someone's on the morning walk. Dog walkers, I think. So yeah, it's not like a baby. I'm the only one here, I've got the whole place to myself. Just like I had the whole beach to myself yesterday. Oh, I couldn't believe the wind. It's like real. I thought the van was going to tip over at one point, and that's like 3.5-4 ton. So yeah, I'm gonna get some breakfast on, I think. But Anglesey is stunning when the weather's nice. Yeah.
don't know where all the sheep have gone. Probably blown away. Those ramps I've got on the tyres, they definitely are worth getting. Because it didn't have like level of that out. So yeah, I'll definitely be using them again. Might even get some more. So I'll do a quick video of the van in bed mode, because I don't know whether I've done any filming of that. So yeah, nice one. Cheers guys, see you in a bit. Well, I'll just put the awning up. Put it up, wound it out rather. But there's still a bit of wind, it's like flapping the side, so I don't know if it's something I've done or whether it is just too windy for it. I need a beast brace up. So yeah, all that set up. So yeah, like, what's up now? Just that little breeze coming in on that side. Just keeps flapping this. So I don't know whether you guys would put up with that. Blended it just to be safe, because obviously they're very expensive, aren't they, these? So yeah. I just thought I'd get it out just to test it. So anyway. So boat over there. Saving boat or something. I don't know what the plan is today. I'm feeling a bit tired after yesterday's walk, so I don't know what to do. I might walk to the village or something, do something a bit different. But I think I'm definitely staying another night. So yeah, all good. See you in a bit, guys. Alright guys, so another top tip. I've made me coffee. And I boiled a full kettle. So I'm going to put the boiling water in this flask here. And then you're not wasting gas then. So that'll stay hot in there for at least 12 hours. So yeah, it's another little top tip. Rather than boiling the kettle every 5 minutes. So now the wind's died down, I've actually moved my van over the other side. So I've got nice views. You know, got better views. So. Doesn't matter where I'm sitting in the van. Or if I'm cooking or whatever. I've just got better views. And hopefully tonight, do more stargazing. If this overcast clears. There's the fort from yesterday. More sheep. So yeah. Another day in Anglesey. Right, so off we go on another little walk. Bit of overcast now. I'm not sure whether to go that way or straight down to the beach. I go down to the beach this way actually. I'll pick up the coastal path from there, and then I'm going to be going this way today rather than that way. Maybe going towards Holyhead. Here, but I just thought I'd come this way because there was a lot of messing about yesterday going down that way. So, but yeah, at least there's no wind, nice and calm today. And we're off again on another walk. So, I guess it's the beauty of working permanent night, you get to. Enjoy your Sundays and your Sunday evenings a lot more as well. So, gonna fit one more walk in today, a few beers, and then a bit of supper later and home tomorrow. But yeah, it's been good so far anyway. So I've got 2 litres of beer in my bag and 1 litre of water. Survival discipline there, isn't it? I've got a pot noodle, a flask of boiling water. Oh, so saying that, I've probably got 2 litres of water.
a litre of cold and a litre of hot. So I hope it's hot enough to do me pot noodle. I honestly think the rain might stay off today. So yeah, just picked up the like a shortcut to the coastal path. I was going to go to the cove. I was at yesterday, but I think I'm going to skip it and just go southeast, is it? So yeah, in a bit. What is going on? There is literally no one around at all. Come a different route down to the beach, so might see some more people, but there's no one at my campsite. There's no one in the village, and there's no one here. It's almost like the Walking Dead's happened and I'm the only survivor. Oh mate.
Are you called me?
Sorry?
Seals.
Seals?
Seals.
Yeah. We have sea lions. This stubborn bastard. You're alright, mate, I'll walk around.
Blocking the path, like.
You alright, fella? The scran's in.
Hollyhead Falls.
So yeah, it's just a farming village. Kind of hoping there's a pub, to be honest.
A church. Hello.
So yeah, this is my last stop, and then I'm going to make way back to camp. So I reckon I've probably done 3 mile the other way yesterday and then 3 mile this way, so I've probably covered 6 miles of the coastal path of Anglesey. See you in a bit, guys. Right, just found a cracking little bay. It's called Church Bay, and there's a cracking little campsite as well. So next time we come, I'll probably test it out, because there's like a little village, little cafe. So, and what looks like a little pub as well, and the campsite looks good. So, another one to come and visit maybe next summer or something. Because, I mean, look at this, it'd be great for the kids. So, and you're right by the coastal path as well. So, yeah, definitely worth checking out Church Bay. See you in a bit, guys. Some of the property here is just unreal. Lovely little part of the world, this. Church Bay, Anglesey. Check it out. So I'm kind of thinking that pointy one is Snowdon, because it's always that pointy. So like, can you see there, that point? That's Snowdon, I think. Could be wrong, like, too sure, but see that in the distance there? I think that's the Isle of Man. Could be wrong, like, but it's gotta be like.
Alright guys, so yeah, awesome 2 day, 2 night stay in Anglesey. Got some nice walks in on the coastal path and up to Church Bay. Just had the worst night's sleep ever. It's been blowing a gale all night, really bad. The van's been blowing everywhere. I had to move my van from one end of the campsite to the other because I was taking a full hit. I was worried solar panels or something were going to blow off the roof, so managed to park at the side of like a bit of a sort of hill to sort of shelter from the wind. Just had some Weetabix. I'm about to have a coffee and then I'm going to let the school traffic and everything die down. I think I'm going to set off in about an hour, so about 10 o'clock I'm going to set off. It'll take me about 2.5 hours to get home. But yeah, brilliant trip, definitely be back. Pengraig Campsite, I think it's called. I'll put all the links and everything in the description. But yeah, really good. The leisure battery was fine. I've managed to work out the water levels and stuff because I've never really been sure on this camper van. So I can now fill it on the inside of the van and from a hose pipe as well. I've been able to fathom that out. And then the hot water and heating system, I think I've managed to suss that now as well, because there was a bit of a discrepancy when using that as well, which was the right way to do it. The only problem with this campsite, there is zero signal, like no signal at all. You get loads of signal on the coastal path by the sea, but up in this campsite for some reason you just can't get signal. And as I was walking in from Church Bay yesterday, because I'd done like a loop, I couldn't even see me van or the campsite or anything. It's like hidden in like a ditch. So I think that might be why I can't get signal. I don't know. If you just walk up the road slightly, that's when you can get signal. So if you had to make an important call or text, you can, you know, you can do that. That's what I was doing. But yeah, the wind. I mean, I can put up with rain, snow, hail. But wind is just something I just don't do. It just frightens me because it always ends up costing money. And obviously I've had no sleep. I think I've had probably about 3-4 hours sleep since midnight last night. It's just a joke. And this is a spring suspension, this van. So it doesn't half go like when the wind, like it's going now and it's died down a lot. So yeah, see you next time, and as I say, this is the first sort of YouTube video I've done, so hopefully I will get better as I go on, and you know, have better content for you as well. So see you next time guys, nice one.